just having someone in your corner and really looking out for you, I think that is awesome. And you know, just if you join the program, you'll see that a lot of people have made those types of connections where it's not like everybody's looking out for themselves. Like, people will post job listings and then people are willing to answer questions that you have. And so I think there's a lot of value in just building that type of relationship and having someone that is, you know, on the same journey with you. I like structure and I like going in with a game plan. And so I initially did, when I first, I guess, got into Trailhead, it was through that free 5-day challenge. And that was awesome. And I found that I was successful with each day when I was getting an email and it was like, hey, do this. But then as soon as that stopped, it was like, well, now what? Like, I don't know where to go from here. And so, that was kind of when I really toyed with the idea of the Talent Stacker program. And come to find out, you know, it's not just what to do after you get certified. It has steps laid out from the beginning of Trailhead to, you know, your completion of Trail. And so for me, I'm a person that likes to complete things. And so with the pacing guide, it really has it broken down by, like, this is what you should complete each week. And so that has been big, like a big motivator, and I guess finishing things in a timely manner. But then on top of that, it really walks you through like the LinkedIn, it walks you through interviewing. You can get feedback based off of like the mock interviews, but also you can watch other people's mock interviews and you know, just learn from what other people have said. I didn't have any doubts with what the program could do. A lot of my skepticism was more if the program would work for me, like with my personality. So it wasn't that the program itself seemed like it was, you know, like a scam or that maybe it was too good to be true. It was more when, you know, I knew going into it that a lot of it would require effort on my part, obviously, but it wasn't just like studying type of effort, it was also putting yourself out there. And so that was where my skepticism came in, was just wondering if this would work for me. And so, but like I said before, you know, I am not the most outgoing person, but even then I was able to get a lot out of the program. I'm naturally like an introvert by nature. Like, I tend to be more on the quieter side. And so one of the biggest things that the program really advocates or pushes for is putting yourself out there, kind of stepping out of your comfort zone, which I didn't do. And for 4 or 5 months, it was me kind of doing my own thing for the most part. Like, I was listening to what the program, you know, told us to do. I updated my LinkedIn. I did everything besides putting myself out there. Like, I didn't really go to the study groups. I updated LinkedIn. I followed the pacing guide, but that was the extent of it. And then I had those, I started applying for jobs and I just wasn't getting anywhere. Like, wasn't getting a call, didn't get any interviews. And then I saw other people were saying that recruiters were reaching out to them. And I was like, wait, hold up. I'm obviously doing something wrong here. And so that was, what was interesting is everything kind of happened really quickly after I started like jumping more into the program. And so like for anybody who is new to the program or kind of in the same shoes that I was in, I would say just go ahead and dive in. You're gonna have to do it eventually. For me, you know, I could have, if I were really like putting my foot or my head to the ground, I could have maybe had a job even sooner than I did now. Timing wise, it just worked out really well. So I had interviewed with 3 different companies. The first 2, I bombed those interviews. I didn't prepare at all for them. And so going into the mock interview, I wanted it to be, because I knew you're gonna get feedback. So I really wanted to get the most I could out of it. And so I prepared for that interview, which was great. One, because the interview ended up going pretty well. But two, I had my third interview like with a different company shortly after the mock interview. And so I think it would just came, like with everything, it just comes down to preparation. You kind of have to do what makes you happy. And when it comes to your career, if you don't already know what you want to do, it's a little bit of a guessing game. And with this, you know, all things considered, it's a relatively cheap way to figure out if this is something that would work for you. You know, if you're not quite ready to jump into the Talent Stacker program, spend a couple of weeks in Trailhead. And once you find that you like Trailhead, the Talent Stacker program only adds to that. And so if you feel like Salesforce is interesting, then you already have what you need, or you already have all the information you need to make a decision in enrolling in a program like this. The way I like to think of it is I was toying with the idea of going to grad school at one point, and this program is like one class. You know, if one class, if it doesn't work out, then you may lose a little money, but then you know, and at least you didn't sink all of that money into a grad school program and then you're, you know, thousands of dollars in debt. And so for me personally, if I were to look back at my younger, my 6 month younger self, that's probably what I would tell myself is, I mean, this is just one class, like, you know, just do it. It's worth it. All of these testimonials are not like fake. Everybody, you can just look at the community too, like spend some time on LinkedIn, look at who, like just look in the community. A lot of people are very active. There's a very, like the Ohana community that's alive, you know, like it's not in healthcare. It's everybody's kind of siloed. They're just doing their own thing. You don't really hear a lot of people communicating, but with Salesforce, there's such a big community where people are so eager to help. Absolutely. So I graduated, I got a bachelor's degree, and I didn't even go to a fancy school. It was a public, and I got in-state tuition, and I was tens of thousands of dollars in debt after completing. And my first job with a degree in my hand, I was making 46 a year, and that was with overtime. And so it was awful. And then, you know, you think about this program, you're paying a fraction of it. Like I don't have to go in debt to pay or to enroll in this program. And what I'm making in my new position is, I don't know the exact number, but it's more than 50% of my first job straight out of school with a degree. And so ROI is like, it's definitely worth it. Even if I didn't even know what ROI meant, you know, like I think anyone who is thinking about going to school or like it's just so much cheaper. And then the income potential doesn't even cap at a certain, you know, like with my current career, I am capped at a certain amount, like, and I'm approaching that amount. And so it's kind of like with this, the within a couple of years, that's already what I would be making at the peak of my nursing career. And so, but then also it's like ROI on time, you know, Salesforce can be done remotely. And if you work for a company where you're completely remote, you automatically get time back in your day. You don't have to commute to work. You don't have to beat rush hour. You don't have to prepare your meals or your lunches. And so it's not just a money thing. It's also getting a little bit of your life back.